An iframe is someone else's website on your website. You make a beautiful website, but you just need something that you don't have. So you can use something called an iframe to punch a hole in your website and show somebody else's website. If you're using an iframe, maybe that's the only thing you can use. Or maybe you're working in a low-code or no-code environment. But you've also got to be careful when using an iframe. This is, at the end of the day, somebody else's website. They can make changes without you knowing, and it'll pop up on your website. Maybe that's good because you don't want to maintain that part of your website, but it is something to keep in mind. You should also know it's an early web technology, which means that there's some kind of weird limitations about how you can style it with CSS. Just expect to deal with some CSS pain. When do you want to punch a hole in your website to somebody else's website? When somebody else is better at something than you are. For example, if you don't want to deal with video players, maybe use an iframe for somebody else's video player. So how can you use an iframe to add a video to your website? I'm so glad you asked. Here at Mux, we now have an iframe option. If you've heard of Mux before, you may know that we already offer our very robust Mux Player as a web component. This allows you to host your player directly from your website. But we heard from some of you that you want an iframe. And to you, we say, we have an iframe. Just upload your video to Mux and copy this code snippet. And we've got some secret Mux sauce that makes the iframe version of the player just a little bit nicer. We can do a little bit more work for you. Let me tell you about that. So this is Mux Player. You can't even tell that this isn't coming from your website. This is coming from our website. This is coming from player.mux.com. Let's take a look. What? There it is, in an iframe. Because it's coming from our website, we can make your player look delicious to social media and SEO. Here in the head, we've got all of your favorite OG tags and Twitter tags so that when you share your video, it looks fantastic. For example, here I want to tell people about my favorite dogs on my favorite social media website. Because of those OG tags, we've got a title and we've got a little preview of our video. We also make the iframe look really good to search engines. If you take a look at the very bottom of the iframe, there's a little bit of secret code called LDJSON. And this tells Google a little bit more about your video. There's even more about the iframe that we haven't talked about yet. For that, there's a whole blog post. Check it out. And if you like our blog posts, definitely subscribe to our newsletter for more hot topics on making video easy.